Hello. In this video, I want to walk through the process of setting up a virtual machine on the Synology DSM system. So I'm going to set up an Ubuntu like mini system, but the technique I use, you can use for different builds and even other distributions. So to get started, we're logged into the DSM interface and we need to install the virtual machine manager. So if we go to the Package Center and we go to All Packages, and it should be, let's see where it's at. Make this full screen. Save. I'll just search for virtual. Oops. Here we go. So we have virtual machine manager, and we'll hit install on this. We'll download. Okay, so it's downloaded. Before we open that, we want to download an ISO. So I'm going to open up another tab here, and I'll just search for Ubuntu Server Mini ISO. And it'll be this first link. It says installation minimal CD. And something important you might notice here is it says that the mini system we're going to be installing doesn't support UEFI mode, so we'll be using BIOS mode. BIOS mode is kind of the old mode, and if you don't understand what that is, it doesn't matter. Just we'll come across that in a minute here. So these are the different builds since the Synology system. Now I should have mentioned first off that this is only going to work on systems that support virtualization. So this isn't going to work on an ARM system. This will work on Intel systems. And I don't know if all of the Synology systems with Intel support virtualization, but this certainly works. I'm on a DS718 Plus that I'm doing this on. So I'm going to get this 64-bit PC. It's AMD 64 x86 underscore 64. And there's three versions here. I'm going to choose 1804 Bionic Beaver. This is a little confusing to me. You'll see this LTS here. This is long-term support. And 1804 is supposed to be a long-term support, which means it should have updates for 5 years, but it doesn't say LTS here. And I don't know if that's a mistake or if I'm missing something here, but I'm going to assume it's an LTS version. I think they just left it off here. So I'll click on this and that will download the ISO, and that's 67 megabytes. So if we go back into the DSM, I'll go to File Station here, and I'll just create a folder. I'll just call it ISO. And you know, I created it in this backup folder, which is fine. I'll probably delete this when I'm done. And we'll look at this. This has downloaded. So I can just drag the download into this ISO. And it says, do we want to overwrite? I'll just say skip. And it's downloading it into this folder now on the DSM. So when we need this install CD when we go into the virtual machine manager to install a virtual machine. So one more thing I will do real quick before we get into the software is I'm going to look up Ubuntu 18.04 minimum requirements. And this pops up, there's an answer here. It says you need a 2 GHz dual core processor, 2 GB of system memory, and 25 GB of free hard disk space. So, and I don't know if it would run on less than this, but I'm going to use this for building our virtual machine. So we've downloaded the ISO. What we want to do now is go into the virtual machine manager. So if we click up here on main menu, virtual machine manager, I'll add this to my desktop. So that should show up here now, and we'll open that up. And it says, welcome to the virtual machine manager setup wizard. The wizard will assist you in setting up virtualization cluster. You will be guided through the following steps. Select volumes to be used as storage for virtual machines. Check if host settings are suitable for running virtual machines. So we'll hit next. And we'll say I want to use the my main volume here, which I have 3.3 terabytes on. I'll hit next. And it will check this open vswitch and ARP ignore. And this open vswitch is disabled. So it will fix that here. It says the previous disabled network settings will be automatically enabled. Take a few moments to reconnect the network. So I'll say yes. So what this open vswitch will do is, right now the Synology NAS has an IP address, but when you build virtual machines, you'll want IP addresses assigned for those virtual machines. So this sets up the networking infrastructure to allow that to happen. So this will probably take a second, and I'll speed the video up here if needed. Okay, so it says the virtualization cluster has been created. You can now start creating your first virtual machine. So I'll hit finish. Okay, so we have the interface here. We're at full screen. Okay, so it says we have one host, zero virtual machine, one storage. So if we go to the virtual machine here on the left side and we go to create, it will give us some options, and we are creating a Linux virtual machine. So we'll hit next. It will say select the storage, and we only have one storage here, so I'll hit next. And then we want to give this a name, so I'll call this Ubuntu Mini. I'm going to assign one CPU. I'll assign two. And then memory, we'll do 2 gigabytes. I'll hit next. And then we want the ISO file for boot up. So we'll hit browse, go into this ISO folder and mini ISO. And then this additional ISO file, this would probably be for something like Windows, if you had a special driver or something like that, which I don't have anything like that. And then for virtual disk, we'll say 25 gigabytes. Okay, so I'll hit next. And it says configure your network, and we have the default VM network. So what this will do is this will assign a IP address using DHCP from the main DHCP router on my network. I'll hit next. It says auto start. If you want to start when the Synology starts up, you can say yes, otherwise no. Here's that BIOS. So we see legacy or UEFI, and it recommends the legacy BIOS. And this distribution I'm using only supports legacy BIOS, so that works out well. We have the keyboard layout. I'm going to choose default. The virtual USB controller I've disabled. You could set this up so the virtual machine has access to the USB ports on there. You might do that if you're scanning or something like that. Then I'll hit next. And we're going to select a user here, so I'll select myself. And then I'll hit next. And then it says power on the virtual machine after creation. So I'll hit OK there, and I'll hit apply. And now you'll see the virtual machine will pop up here. And it says it's running, so I'll hit connect up here. And this will connect us up to, it's essentially like a VNC client, which is like a screen sharing software inside of the browser. So I can go through the install process here. So I'll choose install. I'm using arrow keys and the enter to navigate this. And this isn't the most powerful processor in the world in this Synology, so this will take a little bit of time to install. If you had this on a, you know, a high-end PC, this would probably take no time at all to install. But on here, it'll take a minute. So I'll choose United States. It says you can try to have your keyboard layout detected. I'll say detect keyboard layout. I'll say yes. So I'll go through this process. Okay, it says our keyboard detection is complete. I'll hit continue. Now it's getting the IP address. Okay, now we'll give it a host name. So I'll choose Ubuntu Mini. So I want to go down to continue. You can usually hit tab or hit down to move between the interface. I'll say I'm going to use the United States mirror. I don't have a proxy set up. Okay, and now it's loading the system. Okay, it's asking me to create a user, so I'll just type my name. And I'll give it a password. It's asking if the time zone is correct. I'll say yes. And now we're getting into the disk partitioning, and it says you can do guided use entire disk, you can set up LVM or encrypted LVM, or do manual. So I'll just do the default guided use entire disk option. It'll have me choose the disk we allocated to it. I'll say write changes to the disks. Okay, so it's gone through the install and update process, and then you'll come up upon this screen, and it says, how do you want to manage upgrades? So you can say no automatic updates, install security updates automatically, and manage system with landscape. So I'm going to choose no automatic updates. If you're going to have a system you're not going to pay attention to, but you want it still updated, you'll probably want to choose a second option. Okay, so now we're at a software selection screen. You can choose all sorts of options here. You can set up a full desktop, LAMP server, mail server, Samba file server. There's all these options here. You can do these after the fact too. I'm going to just choose the Open SSH server, and then I'll hit continue. And the Open SSH server will allow us to SSH into the server that we're building. So I'll hit continue. Okay, now it's asking about the bootloader, and it says, do we want to install the Grub bootloader to the master boot record? And I'm going to say yes here. Okay, it says system clocks are generally set to coordinated universal time, UTC. The operating system uses your time zone to convert the system time into local time. It is recommended, unless you use another operating system that expects the clock to be set to local time, is the system clock set to UTC? I'm not real sure, but I'm just going to say yes. And it says installation is complete. I need to remove the CD, which you don't need to do. I'll just hit continue here, and it will restart the system. Okay, so now we have the login. I'm going to click back over here to the Disk Station Virtual Machine Manager, and you'll see we have the name Ubuntu Mini here. It says status is running, high availability is not on, running host DS718, host CPU is 1.2%, and IP. So this IP here is the IP address of the virtual machine, but that won't show up until we install some software. So I'm going to log into here with my username and password, and I'm going to type app. I'm going to type sudo space app update, and that will pull down the latest software. It's going to ask me for my password here. So this is pulling down the list of all the available software. And then I'm going to say sudo app install qemu-guest dash agent. Okay, so now that I have this installed, it allows this virtual machine to talk to the virtual machine manager. And if we go back here, might take a second, but okay, so here we go. So now we have the IP address showing up on this virtual machine here. And so if you shut this down and open it back up, if you don't remember what the IP address is, or if it gives it a different IP address because it's on DHCP, you can always check here. So I really like installing that. So now we have a blank Ubuntu virtual machine instance set up. I don't have a desktop on here. You could install the server version. You could install the desktop version in a similar way and utilize those. And once you get that set up, you can, you know, the sky's the limit on what you can do with this. So if you have any questions on this install process or anything with this, please leave them in the comments. I'll put a link in the description to some playlists I have on Synology equipment. I have unboxings, installs, things like that. If there's anything you want to see, leave a comment down below too. Let's see, if you like this video, please click like, and thanks for watching. Goodbye.